installing the Miui ROM, the one that was just released. I edited it just a couple days ago. It's supposed to be for the US. There's a couple ways we can do this, but the first one I'm going to show you is how to get the ROM to your phone through a barcode scanner. So you get this, you get the barcode scanner, then you go to the website where it says your model number. Put the barcode scanner onto where, and it's going to give you that website. And then you just open the browser, and that's it. On the top, you see it started downloading. Go to the home page. You see on the top, starting to download the ROM. It's 1.8.5. That's the English version. Everything that works or don't work, you're gonna have to look at the developer's page. The link is in the description box. I say again, the links are in the description box. So check it out. Have any questions regarding the ROM? You can find it on there. Your answers, anything. Ask the developer, and don't forget to thank them for the nice ROM. The next one I'm gonna show you how to get it onto your phone is the usual, the USB plug, on the bottom, plug it in. Oh, by the way, this is a Synergy ROM, so it's different on change it to a disk drive. Change your phone into a disk drive, so it'll show up on your computer. So now your phone is in disk drive mode. And the download for Supersonic is done. And then you move the file from your computer. On your machine, it'll look like this. And then you put open folder, show the folders in your phone. And then you open up the page where you have the ROM stored at. And then you just move it into your, make sure you know where you moved it to, because if you don't, then you're gonna end up looking for it on your SD card. That's the other way. So now we're gonna go flash it from your SD card. So the first thing to do is let's check this. It says it's finished. So it looks like it says ROM Miui. It says failed. Okay, we're gonna try to re-download it with the barcode, but let me do this as we move the Miui ROM from get the 1.8. That's the version. Move it onto your SD card should be done in a little bit. Once it's done, so now it's on the SD card. Let's close this out. Let's go back to the phone. Turn it on. Let's get the CRG ROM on it. From in here, go to settings. Go to applications. Development, make sure USB debugging is selected, the one on the top. Let's go back, go to the phone, and we're going to see the software, whatever's in there. since there might be some changes in when you flash the new ROM. So this one would be 424.651.1 2.3.3, the PRI version and the PRL. You can back this up too in recovery. I'll show you how to do that. So now it's power off. Oh, sorry. Let me change this back into charge mode. Done. And let's power it off. After we power it off, make sure it's completely off. I'm gonna take the USB cord off just to make sure that it's completely off. And after it's done, volume key down, power button. Hold it down, let it go to the bootloader screen. Usually when it does this, it means I did it too soon. The phone is not completely off. It's going to go back into Synergy mode. I wouldn't advise you to do that, but I do that because I know how to fix it when it's broken. Let's do it again. Volume button down. Power button. The other thing I forgot to mention is disable fast boot. Go into your settings, disable fast boot to let the checks go through first. After the checks, then you go into recovery. See recovery right there. Power down to select. Let it get into recovery mode. Now the settings on your phone, if you need to back it up. This will be a perfect time to back it up first, but make sure you have a strong battery for doing that, or just leave the USB plug on. So back up and restore. Select that. I've already backed up the ROM, so if I wanted to restore, it'll show the date. You see the date? That's the date I did a backup. It was right after I rooted this 2.3.3. I was the first one to release the video. So that's my backup. So in here, let's do a wipe. Wipe all data. Wipe data factory reset. Do it three times. That's for the third. That's the third for the data and factory reset. Now wipe the cache. I usually wipe it three times. Wipe cache. Wipe three times. And then to get to Delvet Cache, you got to go to Advanced, select Delvet Cache right there. Do that three times. And after that, go back. Go install zip from zip card. I'm sorry, from SD card. Choose zip from SD card. And then we look for that 1.8. That's the one on the bottom right there. So the 1.8, the one that we moved onto the SD card. Or the other way, we downloaded from the QNR scanner, the barcode scanner. Then click this, select, and go install. This is the 1.8 version. Supposedly, it's supposedly for the English version. As you notice, when you root your phone from unrevoke and alpha rev, it gives you the blue screen recovery mode. When I flashed the energy mod on here, the energy ROM on here, it gave me the yellow blue screen. That's a version earlier than the blue screen. So the blue screen, it's the latest. Don't panic, you know, it comes with the ROM. They usually, it says install from SD card complete. Now they install, we go back, and then we reboot system now. Now we all know that the first reboot, it's always going to take a long time, so we're just going to have to wait it out. I think I'm just going to edit the video if it takes any longer, and then come back to you when it's finished rebooting. As I was saying on the recovery, Synergy Mod ROM came with an earlier version of a recovery menu, which is the yellow one. The latest root for Gingerbread 2.3.3, it comes with the blue. So upon flashing ROMs, there are ROMs that are made by developers that it's automatically going to install recovery menus for you. Some may be the latest, some may be the old, some may be the earlier version. That's the Miui ROM booting up. This is supposed to be the English version, so hopefully everything goes well. Finish, I was saying, you don't panic when you see your recovery menu. It's in a different color. It's just that's the recovery menu that comes with the ROM. But whatever you backed up, most important, whatever you backed up, it's not going to go away. It's still going to be in there. So I showed you my backup right before we flashed the ROM. That was the one I backed up. That was the original backup from the blue screen recovery menu from Revolutionary and Alpha Rev. So far, it already read my carrier, and it has my SD card is reading media. Right now, like I said, it's my first time in here too. This is a different version, that's why. Thing when you read the post, you have to look and see what works and what doesn't, because what the dev has posted on his page, he's still working on 4G. So this one, I have 4G in my area. Some of you don't have 4G, but it still has 3G connection, so phone is still loading. We have to give it some time before some lock. It's got a nice feel to it. I think the next video I'll show you guys a review of this 1.8 version. All right, but so far so good. Everything works fine. I just gotta go through it and then I give you a review after. Okay. Other than that, let's see. Let me see the power button. She got some options in there too, so it's pretty good. Miui ROM shutdown screen. See the lock screen. I know we can change all that. But contacts.